टीसी नंबर 310 5 सेकेंड स्टार्ट। मिस्टर चेयरमैन, आई बैग टू मूव दैट दिस हाउस अप्रूव द प्रोक्लेमेशन इशूड बाय द प्रेसिडेंट ऑन द 15th November 2004 अंडर क्लोज 1 of Article 356 of the Constitution, assuming to himself all the functions of the government of Andhra. Sir, the House is fully familiar with both the background and the actual facts which led to President taking this action. The background has been that ever since the formation of the Andhra state, the party position has been vacillating. There have been no elections and with the division of the state, the legislature was also divided and 140 members came away from the Madras legislature and formed the Andhra legislature, and the division between the different political parties was very uneven, and the result was that the government of the day was carrying on with a very slight majority, sometimes one, sometimes two, sometimes a little more, but it was always a very unbalanced thing. Now, sir, in the Andhra state, as you know, the one very big question has been the question of prohibition. Under the constitution, everyone knows that prohibition is a matter of directive principle. The constitution has given a directive that every state government shall aim its policies towards the enforcement of prohibition. In the old Madras state, the government of the day had enforced prohibition thoughtfully the entire state, and that was inherited by the Andhra government. And in that state today, there is a complete prohibition. The Andhra government, after the separation, appointed a committee under the chairmanship of Sri Ramamurthy to go into the whole question, make investigations about the actual conditions as to how far the policy has succeeded and make recommendations. The Ramamurthy committee submitted a big report and made certain recommendations, which were, if I may put it that way, somewhat towards relaxing, if not completely abolishing, this policy of prohibition. We are not concerned here with that particular matter. Now, this report was considered in the Andhra legislature, and a certain resolution was passed in the month of May on the 27th May 2000. Some members were dissatisfied as to the action taken by the government to implement this resolution of the legislature, and notice was given of a motion of no confidence to be moved in October to this effect. Now, after 3 days debate, voting took place on 6 November, and the total strength of the legislature being 140 reality, and it is a very surprising thing that 139 members were present in the House. Only there was one absentee. Now, out of 139, one was the Honorable Speaker, and another member remained neutral and 137 members actually voted, and if you add the speaker, actually 138 members were present and 137 voted. And out of 137, the result of the division was 69 in favor of the motion of no confidence and 68 against the motion. The result was that this motion of no confidence was carried by 1. The ministry made, they pondered over the situation and they submitted their resignation. But along with the resignation, they also said that having regard to this, want to equilibrium and always uncertainties prevailing, it was desirable that there should be a general dissolution so that people may be given an opportunity of having a stable government for themselves, of pronouncing their own opinion upon this big question of prohibition and all other relevant questions. That is what they did. They submitted their resignation and they gave this advice. Now, sir, the governor was faced with a very difficult situation. He sent for and so the leaders of different groups, but these gentlemen, apart from meeting the governor and telling him in conversations as to what they thought of the matter, also issued statement to the press, and these gentlemen stuck to the statement and tendered their advice to the governor to the same effect. Sir, we had given notice of a question of privilege yesterday, and I understand that the Andhra bill is coming up before the other house at 5 p.m. today. Sir, our contention was that it amounted to a contempt of this house and breach of privilege, because the Lok Sabha Secretariat had issued a notice saying that the Andhra bill would be introduced in that house even before the proclamation had been discussed in and endorsed by this house. The constitution makes it clear that this proclamation has to be endorsed under certain limitations by both houses of parliament. Now, sir, we feel that the Lok Sabha Secretariat has anticipated the decision of this house. They should have waited till the verdict of this house on the question of proclamation was known to them. Therefore, I submit that this notice has operated to the prejudice of the house as a whole.